Oh my god, I went live multiple times today. You guys not tired of me yet? So I'm on a little bit later than usual, and that's because Ramel took Emily with him to paddling, and so I took a short little break since I only had the baby and she took a nap, so I went and took a rest too. So that's why I didn't come on until later, and Ramel doesn't come home till probably after 7:30. So hi Sherelle. So I didn't need to rush to get dinner started because they're not going to get home till later. I'm just trying to get on the video so I can see all your comments. So thanks for popping in again. I went on a couple times today. I don't know if you guys caught the churro video, but I was super excited that that worked. And I have never in my life made churros, so I don't know what goes into it when you make it the traditional or regular way. So thankfully we had a few people on that have made them before. So they were saying that they use a piping bag and it can get very messy. So using the sorbet maker actually makes it a lot easier, and it's easy to clean too. Hi Alicia, hi Jane, hi Lenore, hi Noe, hi Dawn, hi Kelly, hi Erica. So I'm slicing up my mushrooms because I'm gonna do pork chops. So I did this this morning for my party that I did this morning at 10, but I marinated extra pork chops for dinner. So that's what we're having. And these pork chops have been sitting in this cilantro lime seasoning since yesterday. I was like, why isn't it not matching up? They're two of the same size. So they've been, all I did was season them. And yes, I put them in a fridge smart just because, good night, Chris. I think it's Christopher, right? I seasoned it and I just put it in the fridge smart just because this was the container I had out. So we're going to use this. I'm not going to put any grease in the pan. The pan is on high heat. The pork chops are going to cook fairly quickly because they're cut pretty thin. I could put some oil in there, but I won't. Since it's pork. So we're just going to throw all this in the pan. After this is done cooking, I'm going to make cream spinach and sauteed mushrooms. So that's what I'm going to do for dinner. And at first I was going to use asparagus and all that stuff, but just, I don't know. I don't want to do too much. I will add some olive oil to this. Not that it's sticking, but because there's seasoning, the dry seasoning on top. Can you guys see inside the pan? Not really. It's not that it's sticking. I can smell like that. Oh, you're on vacation, Kelly? So it's not sticking. I know you guys can't really see the pan. It's not sticking. It's not, you know what? I don't think I need olive oil. Oh, it smells good. So that's why I have the big pan out. This is my favorite size pan, actually. This is the 5-quart sauteuse pan. I think it's called a sauteuse pan. So I'm just gonna let this brown. I'm slicing up my mushrooms. This is gonna go in afterwards. There's all these cables here because I gotta keep my camera plugged in. Hi, Dana. So I'm just slicing this. We have a slicing wedge, but I don't want to take it out. We're just gonna slice it like this. If I was doing like a lot of mushrooms, then I would probably take it out, but I'm not. So while that's browning, I'm just slicing my mushrooms to put in afterwards because I'm actually going to also do, I don't know if I said that already, cream spinach. So for the cream spinach, it's going to be very, very basic. I think I made it before for you guys. I'm just using heavy whipping cream, a shallot, and garlic. That's it. Hi, Haley. I think that's all I'm going to use. I'm going to save this for breakfast. Cream cheese from Costco. I think I might put some of this in the cream spinach along with the heavy cream. Oh my god, the pork chop smells really good. So I just looked up a very quick recipe for cream spinach. It's cream and spinach and garlic, but I wanted to see what else people put in there, so we're going to put some of this cheese in it. It's Parmigiano Reggiano. We're going to put that in there too. So let me flip these pork chops. Ooh, they're nice and seared real good. And if the kids don't want to eat this, they're going to starve, just kidding. I'm going to have to figure something out for them. Macaroni and cheese, salmon, whatever. Sometimes they don't like, but you know what? The baby likes spinach and she likes cabbage. And can you guys see that? So I just flicked them. Loud, the sizzling. Ta-da. Yeah, so I bought these from Costco, actually. A huge pack. So there's a lot more pork chops I gotta cook up. A lot more. I bought a huge, huge package of it. My water. These pork chops are going to be done in a minute. Wow, that's good. I need a microwave plate because Ramel doesn't get home for like another hour and a half. So he's going to need to reheat it. So I'm going to put it on a microwavable plate. I like it when it's almost burnt like this, where it's browned really good, because I like that crunch of the pork. Ooh, they're done. That was fast. Look at that. That was very fast. Come on. This guy doesn't want to come to me. Oh my god, he wants to fight me. You want to fight me? Okay. I'm going to cook that a little bit longer. This one looks good. This one needs a little bit more. That one's good. So it got brown because of the seasoning too that's on there. This is done. Ta-da! Pork, the other white meat. Whatever happened to those commercials? They're gone now. Oh my god, this one doesn't want to get out. It wants to get sunburnt. So there we go. So there's the pork chops. We just have four. It's just me and Ramel and the kids, so... Now, I need to lower the heat a little bit because this sucker is hot. And now I'm going to add the butter to the pan. I don't want to put the whole thing. Because now we're going to brown the mushrooms. I want to brown these mushrooms in butter. I'm not going to put any garlic in it. It's just going to be mushrooms with the butter. Because the garlic and stuff is going to go in the cream spinach. And we're going to be eating it all together anyway. So if you want, you can do garlic powder. But I'm going to keep it basic. It's just going to be... Butter. Okay. These are really big mushrooms too. This also came from Costco. Oh my god, it smells so good. Is there, who else is on here that's doing the keto life, like the low carb thing? Seems like everyone is doing it now. The low carb diet, paleo, whatever you want to call it. And I started drinking my lemon water out of the jug because nobody else is drinking it but me. And it's super yummy. Even yummier when it's ice cold. One thing I learned last night was when I punched in this. I learned that one cup of lemon juice has 20 grams of carbs in it. One cup's a lot. Nobody in their right mind drinks one cup of lemon juice. So I'm like, unless I drink that entire 2-liter bottle in one sitting, I'm not going to hit my carb number. It's going to be a very minimal amount of carbs. Because that one cup of lemon juice I put in there the other day, we would drink some and I would refill it with water. And drink some and refill it with water because it was really lemony the first batch. So just so you know, lemon juice has carbs in it. That was a aha moment for me when I plugged it into the app. I'm like, lemon juice has carbs in it? What the heck? It's lemon. But, you know, it's a fruit. So, I'm going to let this kind of brown a little bit longer. And then we're going to do the spinach. And dinner's going to be done. Look, it's Gary. Hi, Gary. Kabakungan. Mashed potatoes are my fave, too. You don't know mashed potatoes are my fave. But... When I see the weight loss and I see the pounds coming off and I feel better, I don't really crave it. I know you guys are. I know you guys are, but I'm just wondering if there's anybody else that's doing it, because it seems to be all the rage on social media now. I have this thing on medium high. I'm going to turn it down a little to medium because I don't want to burn it. But these are done. I'm going to pull these out because it's going to keep cooking after I pull it out of the pan. But there's the mushrooms with the butter. I use the keto diet app. And in Jay's group, they mentioned the carb manager app. So there's different apps you can use, but that's the one I use. So there's the sauteed mushrooms. That's going to go with the pork chops, which are done right here. Oh, look at all the juices coming off of that. I'm going to throw these in the microwave just because I don't want it sitting out. I'm just going to put it in here for safekeeping. And then we're going to do our spinach, and then dinner is done. So the spinach, it said to saute butter with a shallot and natural sugar. That's it. That's it. But, oh my God, that was a killer, though, because I was like, oh my God, I freaking love lemon juice. So you're telling me I can't even have that? But you know what? You got to look at the amount of servings you're having also. It's not just about that you drank a whole cup of lemon juice. You're not drinking the whole cup of spinach. So in here, I have about 7 to 8 garlic cloves and a shallot. And I'm going to finely mince it right now in this chopping prep, right? And again, I want this super finely minced because I want this to mix really well with the spinach. Gary calls me Terry, by the way. Terry is my nickname growing up. And that's because my middle name is Teresa. Maria Teresa. My halo used to be white. It is now black. Ha 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 ha. Yes, I'm using my hands. I don't want to go digging for the spatula and wash more dishes. Yes, this is a pink one. And for a long time, I refused to use it because I wanted it to be for display, but there came a time where I needed to, so now we're using it. My God, I have this thing on low, medium low, and it's still too high. Woo, this sucker smells good. Oh my God, I wish you guys could smell this. Is Paco on? Because I could use his help right now. Oh, okay. Good night, Kelly. So this was all that spinach that I spun. And I spun dry. I washed and spun dry. So we're going to just add it in bunches. Because you guys know it cooks down into nothing. And then you have to add more. So I'm just going to fill this up. It's my food, I know. There's some people that just go, oh my lordy. This is not a cooking show. This is Maria cooking for her family. But you guys know that. Okay, so I have the heat on like 3. So it's very, very low. Because I don't want to burn my garlic and my shallots. Or the butter. Oh my goodness. I'm going to get the cover because I don't want it to... Everything's falling apart. Everything's falling out of the cabinet. I want it to cook down because I'm going to make a huge batch of this spinach. And then while that's cooking, how long have I been on? Only 13 minutes. It's pretty fast. So now we're going to cut a hunk of this cream cheese. Oh my gosh. I still have yet to find a good way to store this because this is a huge block of cream cheese. What I have been doing, the spinner is available until tomorrow, Dana, and once that's gone, it's gone, because we don't have it in our regular catalog. What I have been doing with this is I just take like saran wrap or whatever, and I cover this, and I seal it up real tight so that the air doesn't get to it. But this bar, there isn't really a Tupperware container that I could find that will hold it unless I cut it in chunks and then transfer it into another container. So that's probably something I'm going to have to do. And I'm going to have to do it after this video because I have to go and find a container that will hold this ginormous 3-pound block of cream cheese. So I'm going to add this to the cream spinach. I need to cut it in like smaller increments here. Wow, look at how fast this cooked down. Can you guys see? So So yes, the spinner will be gone after tomorrow. We love spinach in this house, especially cream spinach. Once this cooks down. Yes, Dana. Yes, so it ends tomorrow. So you don't want to miss it, because once that's gone, it probably won't come back out for another year. And I don't know what the price will be next year, too. Inflation and all that good stuff. Hi, Mersada. Hi, Lisa. Lisa is also a Tupperware consultant. And I met Lisa through a friend, Ren, Rendolyn, who sometimes pops on here from high school. Such a small world. They're cousins. So I did a party with them last year. It was so much freaking fun, I swear. And then I do work with Lions Club. So we were doing that cleanup in Eva Beach, and her brother is a policeman with Weed and Seed. I was like, oh, well, that explains why you guys look so familiar. You guys look so alike. Because I didn't know until afterwards. Okay, so I'm going to kind of stir this up to get the cooked spinach up and away. Because I want all of it to mix with the garlic and the shallots, which got a little extra brown. More brown than I anticipated. I swear this pan gets hot and stays hot really efficiently. Okay, so far so good. I'm gonna throw this in because this is gonna take a while too. This is cream cheese. I'm just gonna add it in here. It wasn't on the recipe, but I'm gonna add it in here because I gotta use it or it's gonna get rotten, and I hate throwing away food. So I'm gonna add that in there. I'm also going to add more spinach because it's starting to cook down again. This is a lot of spinach. But remember, we don't eat rice. So this spinach is going to take the place of starch for us. This will give us some good iron numbers, right? Too bad I'm not donating blood. So tomorrow, I'm supposed to go to the Satellite City Hall. hi, Annette. Hi, Barbara. To go and do some car stuff, because Shelby's registration for her car expired and I have to go and renew it. And I'm not looking forward to that because the lines for our Satellite City Halls here are ridiculously long, and I have the two little ones, so to stand in a line that long with the little ones, oh god, I am not looking forward to that at all. And then I forgot that I had made that commitment with Shelby, and I had posted in my VIP that I would do a live video with everybody at 10 o'clock tomorrow. So I'm hoping that I can get done in time so that I can do my live with everybody. So Barbara, according to the scale, hi Judy, I lost about 12 pounds in the last 2 months. I lost the most in the first 2 to 3 weeks, and then I kind of just stayed at that number. But I don't just go by what the scale says. I go by how my body feels and my clothes fit. So I have been able to fit into size 13 shorts and pants, which is something I have not been able to do in probably 15 to 20 years. So that's pretty awesome. And even Ramel noticed. So I was wearing shorts and he's like, where'd you get those shorts? Because I have not worn shorts like jeans or khaki or any of those shorts, kinds of shorts, for years, probably over 6 or 7. I've always used LuLaRoe or something stretchy because I did not want to have to fight with a button or a zipper and wearing short pants. I did not feel comfortable. But I went and bought a pair of Dickies shorts from Walmart, and they fit. And so it felt great to be able to wear that and not feel so like, I mean, my thighs still rub, but I mean, I was able to put it on and be comfortable and not feel really that self-conscious about it. So that was really good. That's a win for me. And so I have tried to lower my carb intake as well as my sugar, but I have days where I still eat a little. Like today, I had a couple little churros, but I'm not going to beat myself up over that. And the scale is a liar. It is. The scale doesn't lie to Ramel. Ramel probably lost over 20, almost 30, and Paca said he had lost over 60 pounds since changing his diet, so we know that it works. We just have to be consistent and try our best to make good choices. And you know what? Sometimes you just eat what you eat. Like, I mean, I went to McDonald's and I ate chunks, but I just did not eat the whole hash brown, or I didn't eat the entire, I won't eat the entire french fries. And you know when you go, they always ask you if you want it large or small or medium. I always tell them I want small. They do that to upsell you. So now I'm going to add the cream. And I'm not measuring, I'm just pouring. I'm going to assume that this is about 3/4 of a cup to 1 cup. But I have it on 4 now, very low heat. And then once this mixes in, the cream cheese will get incorporated in there. And then this is done. So this doesn't take long, right? 20 minutes, not bad. Right, the scale is just a number, just like your age. I could actually put more spinach in here. Oh my God, this looks really yummy. I just have to add salt and pepper. Can you guys see? It's hard to see because of where the camera is. And I'm having a hard time with it because I have the camera plugged into the power. Hold on, I'm going to unplug it. Because this Mevo camera, the battery life on it is not the best. Is that better? No, it's not. Because you can't see inside the pan. Let me know if that's better. I think you can see a little bit more here. So I have it on a very low heat. It's on 4. I don't want to burn anything. I'm just trying to warm up the cheeses and melt it. Because now I'm going to add the Parmesan and the... What is this? Parmigiano Reggiano. That's what it is. Yay. The baby is playing. Yeah, she's throwing Tupperware and she's also playing with the water machine. So yay me. Yay me. Okay, so a little Himalayan pink salt and fresh black pepper. Simple, right? I think I'm going to have to add a little bit more spinach to this and let that cook down with the rest before we eat, because this is not going to be enough for me and Ramel. Cream spinach is a fave of ours. And then he'll have extras to pack for lunch tomorrow. Yeah, look. So I put, look at how much spinach is in. I'm going to move the camera. Maria, move the camera, not the pot. So that's how much is in here. This is a 5-quart, by the way. So that's how much I'm making. And I put the spinach away already. I'm going to leave it then. We're just going to leave it the way it is. So now let's just sprinkle some of this cheese on there. Oh my gosh. Let me turn off the heat too, because this thing is going to retain heat. I love Parmesan cheese. I eat it as a snack. Oh, oh my God. I eat it as a snack, but it has to be shaved. Oh, thank you, Aisha. I'm 40, believe it or not. I'm old. I'm getting old, let me put it that way. So I turned off the heat. I'm just going to let that cheese melt in there. I want more. Who doesn't want more cheese? We want more cheese. Turn off the camera. The baby is wreaking havoc on my Tupperware over there. Okay. So with that like that, I'm going to cover it. I turned off the heat already, so it's already done. I'm going to cover it so that it just... I'm going to leave it tilted so that the steam can escape, because I don't want it to collect any water inside. I want it to be like rich and creamy. So there's that. That's done. So I got dinner done in about 30 minutes today. It took maybe 5-ish to peel the shallot skin off and peel the garlic. So that was fairly quick. I gotta put this away on the Tupperware first. So dinner is finished. I'm pretty sure the baby is gonna wanna eat the cream spinach. Hi, Yvette. Okay. Yeah, you wanna say hi? Over there. Say hi. Hey. Dinner is done. She knows when it's done. That's why she comes over here and bothers me. See? Ooh, that looks so good. Oh my God. Look at. Look at that. So good. So I'm just going to stir this. I want to get that cheese incorporated in here. You could even add mozzarella cheese to this if you wanted to, but I don't want to. I had some, I heated some mozzarella in the pan, and mozzarella doesn't heat like cheddar does. It's very gooey. So I heated that up, and the pan, it doesn't stick, so I could actually flip it like an omelet. And I ate that as a snack yesterday, so I'm kind of mozzarella'd out. So we're just going to do Parmesan. So dinner is done, guys. They all said hi, Christine. Say hi. Look at her waving. Look at you. You could even add asparagus to this. Just top asparagus on top. You can add broccoli to this. Whatever you want. Anything goes good with a cream sauce, yeah? So that's it. Dinner's done. I'm going to feed the baby, give her a bath. And hopefully she gets ready for bed, yeah? So that mommy can finally get in the swimming pool because it's really humid today, yeah? I took a shower, but now I'm cooking. I'm hot again, so now I want to go into the swimming pool. So we're going to eat and take a shower and go to sleep, yeah? Yes? Yes? She's looking at herself. Yes? Yes? Okay. Okay. Oh, she wants to eat. Okay. So say bye, everybody. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Let me go and get my phone so I can reach it. Okay. So say bye-bye. Bye-bye. See you tomorrow. Bye, everybody.